Once VEGF was identified as the factor X molecule responsible for proliferative diabetic retinopathy, researchers focusing on other causes of blindness began investigating. Over the span of a few years, VEGF was proven to play a role in many diseases that lead to vision loss, including retinopathy of prematurity, central retinal vein occlusion, and age-related macular degeneration. The researchers realized the best way to prevent blindness from these conditions would be to stop the actions of the VEGF molecule.
And so over the next several years, we worked with Dr. Ferrara and Genentech and a variety of other groups to look at inhibitors, first in cell culture and then in animalized, and then eventually these went into clinical trials in humans.
The results of clinical trials investigating the effectiveness of these medications for a variety of diseases were published in 2010, and the anti-VEGF injections were rapidly incorporated into practice, proving to be twice as effective at vision improvement and three times more effective at preventing vision loss as compared to laser treatment.
So this is a huge advance in the treatment for diabetic patients, not just type 1, but and type 2 as well.
The treatments start with 7 to 8 injections during the first year and get progressively fewer over 4 years. Eventually, the patient might not need any more treatments to maintain good vision. The magnitude of this discovery has not gone unnoticed. In 2014, the Antonio Champali Mo Vision Award was presented to researchers involved in developing anti-VEGF agents, including Joan W. Miller, Evangelos S. Grigoudis, and Patricia A. Damore of Massachusetts Eye and Ear Infirmary, Napoleon Ferrara and Anthony P. Adamus of Genentech, along with Dr. King and Dr. Aiello. The award, considered the Nobel of Eye Research, recognized the researchers for their work in bringing the injectable treatments to fruition. To date, anti-VEGF injections have prevented blindness in nearly 300,000 people.